Thank you. David. And the only food product we allow in the sanctuary is water or cough lozenges. And we would appreciate if you would respect that. Let's begin our service this morning with a reading of the 23rd Psalm. So if you would just like to relax and close your eyes for a moment and listen to the words of this beautiful scripture. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. And so our first song this morning will be Morning Has Broken, which is one of Lita's favorite songs. Yeah. We are gathered here today to celebrate the life of Lita Angel Tunich Woods and to reaffirm our faith in life eternal as we bless this loved one on her way. It is our prayer that from Reverend Ken, would you step out and shut it off? All right. It is our prayer that from this time forward, we may never think of Lita as limited by time or form, but always as a living soul continuing on the pathway of life, ever in God's wise and loving care. One of the greatest challenges that all of us meet is the challenge that we call death. Let us approach this time of readjustment by turning to the God presence within ourselves. Let us give our loved one the strength of our own increased understanding as we bless Lita on her way. It is well at this time for us to recall one of the promises given to us in the Bible, that we may reaffirm our faith in God's plan of good for each of us. And this comes from John 11:25. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. Life being of God and actually being an extension of God into creation can under no conditions be lost. Life is eternal. It never ceases to exist. It does not allow itself to be lost or ended any more than God, our creator, sustainer, allows itself to be lost. There is not now, never has been, and never can be any absence of life anywhere, anytime, because there can never be an absence of God. We may fail to recognize life in a particular form as certain cells grow through a time of change, or we may close our spiritual eyes and refuse to recognize the presence of God as life. But that does not change the truth of being, the truth of God, as the living presence in every created thing. What happens when the individual goes through the experience we call death? This is simply the separation of the soul from a particular body. The body is merely the clothing that the soul has worn for a time. In this process called death, the clothing is discarded and the soul goes on to its next experience in divine unfoldment. As we lay aside a garment at the end of the day, so Lita has laid aside the garment of the flesh. Although invisible to us, Lita continues her soul experience in another sphere of life. She's not dead. She's moving on to something else, something grander. And I would like to share a poem by James Dillett Freeman called The Traveler. She has put on invisibility. Dear Lord, I cannot see. But this I know, although the road ascends and passes from my sight, that there will be no night, that you will take her gently by the hand and lead her on along the road of life that never ends. And she will find it is not death, but dawn. I do not doubt that you are there as here, and you will hold her dear. Our life did not begin with birth. It is not of the earth. And this that we call death, it is no more than the opening and closing of a door. And in your house, how many rooms must be beyond this one where we rest momently? Dear Lord, I thank you for the faith that frees, the love that knows it cannot lose its own, the love that looking through the shadows sees that you and she and I are ever one. She's always going to be a part of us. Always. And she is only a memory away. That's how close she still is. And now we're going to hear Perhaps Love by John Denver.
Perhaps love is like a resting place, a shelter from the storm. It keeps to give you comfort, it is there to give you warmth. And in those times of trouble, where two arrows double, the memory of love will bring you home.
Perhaps love is like a window, perhaps an open door. It invites you to come closer, it wants to show you more. And even if you lose yourself and don't know what to do, the memory of love will see you through.
In this gathering of loved ones and friends, we are particularly aware of the love and friendship for this woman we have known, and we are saddened in the thought that something precious has gone out of our life. But we know that it is not the outer face or form that draws a host of friends. Rather, it is the inner qualities of love, strength, and joy that come from the heart of God and find expression in those with whom we share rich experiences. I want to share some personal information about Lita. I'm sure many of you know this, but I learned a lot about her that I didn't know before. And then after I share this, I'm going to open the floor for sharing from the audience here. Lida Angel Tunich was born July 15, 1939, in Detroit, Michigan. She married Edmund George Woods in August of 1960 and was blessed with four children who survive her: Jeff and wife Tanya, John, James and daughter Stephanie, and great-grandchildren Jarrett, Liam and Scarlett, Trieste and her husband Kurt. Also, she is survived by two of her brothers, Harold and his wife Sheila, and Carl. Her brother Timothy is deceased, but his wife Barbara survives him. Throughout her life, Lida was a busy woman, and if you knew her, you knew she was always busy. She worked as a nurse, as a tooth fairy dental tech, a home healthcare worker, and most importantly, a mom. And Trieste told me that their friends used to come around to the house and everyone called her mom. Mm-hmm. All were welcome. She just gathered everybody in. Here at Center of Enlightenment, Lida was a wonderful asset and served our church for many years, doing everything from gardening to housekeeping. She served on our board of trustees for several years and was the building trustee and oversaw many projects and renovations, especially the flood of 2014. Our entire fellowship hall was stripped because everything was ruined by the flood. And so Lida and Trieste took charge of that project and recreated a beautiful space for us. So we thank you. We've enjoyed it all these years. And I have to be honest and say, we have really missed her. We have really missed her, haven't we, Ken? Yeah. For those of us that have known her a long time, we really miss her. So I'm going to open the microphone and you'll have to come up here to share because we have people on Zoom and they won't be able to hear you from the audience. So do we have anyone that would like to come up and share? This is son number one.
Yeah, it's an obligation at this point.
I understand that. I'm a number one child.
Yeah. So I've pulled three things out of the hat to share. And I guess the first and earliest one would be that she bought me, well, music was very important to her. And I think she kind of pushed it on me a little bit because she bought me a Magnus chord organ when I was like 6 years old, and which started a lifelong process of me trying to do something with music. So it's been both a curse and a blessing, but
that's what moms do.
Yeah. So, but she loved music. And if I could just add an aside that she loved to sing, but she wasn't necessarily the best singer. And my sister and I were, there she is. We always joked that she was a warbler. Like she could sing any song and turn it operatic, I guess, in a way, like with a warbly soprano type voice. And, but we loved that about her, didn't we? Yeah. Okay. And then next one would be a story about me and my wife, actually, is that when we got married, I said, Tanya, why don't you make some potato salad like my mom made? And
that was your first mistake.
Yeah. And it was early in the marriage. And so what, finally, we get out to the patio and I'm sitting down and I get this potato salad and it had curry, grapes, walnuts. It tasted kind of like an Indian carrots. Okay, yeah. And tasted kind of Indian. It was like you taste it and you're like you're expecting Coke, but you get root beer and meat stuffing. Yeah, I'll let you tell that story. But so it wasn't quite the same, but eventually Tanya learned how to make potato salad just like my mom, which is downstairs. So try the potato salad. It's the same recipe. And that was my request for the luncheon today. And I guess the third thing was when we were at the nursing home, they kept playing her. They don't know, but they kept playing her Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin, you know, the Rat Pack kind of music. Because, well, they're old. They must like that kind of music. But honestly, my mom liked Neil Diamond and Cat Stevens and Harry Chapin. I was just going to say, because when they had an Alexa there, and I would say, Alexa, play, and I'd recite her favorite people. And when I played her Harry Chapin, she actually teared up. It was like she remembered like a whole part of her life. It brought back a whole part of her life that she hadn't thought about in a while. And I was really happy to share that with her. And anyway, those are my thoughts.
I did forget to mention that Lita served as one of our choir members. And we loved her. That warbly little soprano voice was a real asset to us. So anyway, do we have anybody else that would like to come up and share Trieste?
I'd like to thank you all for coming, friends, family, everybody that loved her. This picture that's up here was one of the last pictures taken. It was at the memory care facility, and it was their Christmas party. And we didn't know what it was going to be like or anything. We thought maybe they were going to have music because they had a stage. And, you know, so they hauled us all up to the second floor for the memory care people to eat. And so they could kind of watch them all. And I had to wrangle a few from escaping, but they were a little short staffed, so I tried to help. But she, I hadn't seen her that happy in a long time. She was enjoying the party and the festivities and the meal and just everything about it. And I did not know until I asked my brother when we were cleaning out her things that she had this blanket on her bed that I had no idea where it came from. I just thought it was somebody else because she was always, every time I went, she was wearing somebody else's clothes. So who knows where it came from. But I had to leave the dinner early, and my brother stayed with her, and he told me that she won that in their little raffle. So Jeff's going to get that because he was there for it. But one of the last time my husband and I went to see her before we went to Florida, we found her in the dining room area, and they were playing we turned on John Denver, but they were playing like Frank Sinatra or something. I'm like, no. So I told Alexa to play John Denver. She got the biggest smile on her face, and she just started singing. And the amazing thing is that she could sing an entire song, but she couldn't put out a sentence. And so that shows what muscle memory is, you know? And so that day we were there for a couple hours, and I said, you know, we got to go, Mom, you know, we got to go pack and get ready to go to Florida. And she grabbed my hand and she would not let go. And she just was smiling and happy. And that's how I choose to remember her, smiling and happy.
Sorry. Do we have any more sharing? Okay.
I got to meet Lita for the first time when we both worked under GM's Earth Angels. And Lita was a fellow co-worker of mine. And we had a case with a lady named Sylvia. Sylvia was a riot, to say the least. But Lita was always so compassionate and caring and being there with her and, you know, doing everything that Sylvia wanted to do. Mm-hmm. One of the things that Sylvia liked to do was ride around to the same places and go to Costco for samples and all of that. And Lita was right on board with it. She was ready to go. And so I got to enjoy quite a few memories with Lita taking care of Sylvia. And then I actually took over the company and Lita then was working under me. Unfortunately, I don't know a lot about business, so I couldn't keep the company going. But then I got the call that Lita needed some help under Triosk, and I was very blessed to be able to go and sit with her one day a week. We'd walk Baxter the dog, and Baxter would come in delighted to see me and jump up on Lita and jump up on me, and it was like back and forth. But Lita just loved Baxter, and she'd be like, he's sitting right on my chest, you know? So it was like just one of those very nice memories. And the one time she was like, I really want something sweet. And at that time I was doing like coming for a couple of hours, leaving and coming back. So I went and I got her some ice cream from the local ice cream shop in Clawson, and I brought it back to her, and she was like, oh, I have something sweet. She was so delighted and excited about it. But, and all the conversations I got to have with her while I was taking care of her and watching the chickens in the backyard, she was really happy to do that. But Lita was very much a bright soul, and her smile was infectious, and she always wanted to be that listening ear and being supportive to anybody she knew. So it was an absolute blessing to A, be working with her, and B, take care of her at the end. And I'm thankful for that.
Thank you.
No, it's your turn.
Hi, everybody. I just have to say that Lita and I go back 1975, them and her dental technician fairy family. And a lot of us stayed in the dental field. When we started at Woods Dental, I was in high school, and Lita kind of took me under her wing. And I met my next lifelong friend, Carol, who met Lita way early on and stayed close so many years, but we were a family. We knew long enough. And then I opened my own lab and Lita came and worked for me, and we traveled and we'd go to Chicago. And I'll tell you, Lita was a blast. This girl could party. Like, you could not keep up with her energy. But if you knew Lita real well, if she was around electronics, they didn't really work around here. She could like pick up a phone and it's not working. She would pick up an electric something and it would just go out, and she'd say, can somebody come in and turn this back on again? Cause it's not working for me. We all got on an elevator and the elevator wouldn't work. The door wouldn't close. She goes, it's me. And she gets off the elevator. The door closes.
What is that at the bottom floor? Like, what the heck just happened? Yes,
it's me. Elevators and me, we don't get along. I just do the stairs. So we had 40 years of just having so much fun. She came and stayed at our house. My husband would call us the storm cookers. We would go in the house and just start pulling food out of the fridge, and she'd start cutting stuff up and we'd start frying things. We didn't even know what dinner would be till it was on the table. And Lita would always say, I'm going, kicking up my heels and kicking at the chandelier. God bless her. She did. She enjoyed life to the end. She really did. So I love you, family.
Boy, it must have been a hoot to know her back then.
That's another thing. I've just got to say one thing here. She was a hoot. You all know her. She always had something good to say about somebody. And if you lost something, we say it to this day. As Linda would say, just put it out there in the universe and it'll come back to you. And you talk about memory, the memories you remember. And so that's what I want to say about Lena. She always had something good to say about somebody. Put it out there in the universe, it'll come back to you. And I read her letters in the back about her, you know, her thoughts, her feelings and everything. And it was really nice. And she'll never be forgotten. So
anyone else? I have a feeling when you get downstairs for the luncheon, you're going to have a lot more stories to share.
My name's Bonnie. You haven't introduced yourself, but through some of the stories I recognize. And I just wanted to say to Trieste and to Jeff particularly, thank you for letting me be part of the family. That I just knew Lita for probably the last 40 years of her life, but forever young. Yeah. That you can, you know, see from the very final picture that she was still the angel.
Well, when you have that joy in your life, you never get old. So I think I'm going to have to do more cultivating of joy. There you go. Each one has a part to play in God's plan for eternal life. And all the faith and inspiration we have shared makes us better able to fulfill our part in the expression of truth. Our greatest tribute to Lita is the continuing unfoldment of the Christ ideals of courage, faith, strength, and yes, joy in our own life. Perhaps the reason for sadness and grief at this time is that we feel there is nothing more we can do for this loved one who has gone on. We want to express our love, to give something in return for the loving gifts of the years. And so let's just take a moment to listen to Touch the Sky.
I'm not afraid to die.
Lita, who has gone into a new sphere of life, has performed a certain work here, fulfilled a place and a purpose best known to God. A part of our work is always the giving of inspiration to others. We cherish the joy, the faith, the love that have been part of the inspiration spread by Lita. And we shall live a fuller, happier, more productive life because we have participated in this relationship. Every one of us has our stories about our relationship with Lita. Some funny, some dramatic, some sad, some happy. They're all different, but they're all wonderful. This then is our gift to Lita, our gift of accepting the challenge and of living our life to the best of our understanding and ability. And so I would like you to close your eyes for just a moment and think of one thing given to you by Lita, whether it was a physical gift or something intangible, a great memory. And as you hold to that thought, it is never too late to give. Another great gift we can give anywhere on the path of life is a loving thought. Even the tangible things we do for others are just outward evidence of a thought. We cannot do tangible things for Lita now, but we can think lovingly of her. And we can give Lita the blessing of our faith in her divine potential and pray for her spiritual progress. You know, we all do learning here on Earth. But when we leave Earth, our learning is not finished. It has a new beginning. Through the language of prayer, we extend the blessings of mind and heart to Lita. To her, we say, we know that your faith is a lamp unto your feet. We know that you are secure in God and in life that is endless. Our prayer for you is this. And if you know this, you can say it with me. The light of God surrounds you. The love of God enfolds you. The power of God protects you. The presence of God watches over you. Wherever you are, God is. And in unity, we used to say, and all is well. When you're with God, all is well. And the thing is, we're never separate from God. So all is well. We do not say goodbye to you, Lita. We say Godspeed on your way. We remember that we are always one in spirit, and you are only a thought away. We let you go on to new experiences in expression, and we behold you as God sees you, a radiant, ever-living, ever-loving child of the Most High God. We release you to your highest good. And so let us pray. Loving Spirit, we give thanks that you strengthen us and lead us on our way as we make our own adjustments in the days to come. We give thanks for guidance, understanding, strength, peace, and love. And so let's say together the Lord's Prayer, and we're going to be using trespasses. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I have a poem here that Trieste asked me to share with you. I did this at another memorial service, and it was shared with me by Reverend Kathleen Hellenberg, who was sitting in the back. I did it for her husband's memorial service. It's called Togetherness. Death is nothing at all. I have only slipped away into the next room. Whatever we were to each other, we still are. Call me by my old familiar name. Speak to me in the same easy way you always have. Laugh as we always laughed at the little jokes we enjoyed together. Play, smile, think of me, pray for me. Life means all that it ever meant. It is the same as it always was. There is absolute, unbroken continuity. Why should I be out of your mind? Because I am out of your sight. I am but waiting for you for an interval somewhere very near, just around the corner. All is well. Nothing has been lost. One brief moment and all will be as it was before. Only better, infinitely better. My journey is bringing me closer to the divine presence. For love doesn't make the world go round. Love is what makes the ride worthwhile. And so it's at this time that we commit the soul of Lita Angel Tunich Woods into the care and keeping of God. And so let's pray. Loving Spirit, we know that you are here as everywhere, blessing us in this moment as we face the days ahead. For Lita, it is not death, but dawn, a new beginning, and we bless her on her way. We release Lita in her journey forward, and we let her go. As we turn to face the work that lies before us, we know that all the good we have shared with Lita makes us richer and better able to fulfill our part in the challenge of living. We thank you, loving Spirit, for your love and ever-present light on Lita's way and our way. In the name of the living, loving Christ presence. Amen. And now we have a solo that will be closing out our service by Darlene. And I'm excited.
I bet.
Thank you. So I didn't come up and share because I thought I would share when I came to sing. And I was thinking about, excuse me a minute. I was thinking about this room and being here and the sun shining in it and being in Trieste and Lita's kitchen. And when Lita came into my life, how much I needed her. Her energy and her smile and her warmth as a mother, and how grateful I was for that. And I didn't really realize that until you said, think about the gift that she gave you and how overwhelmed with happiness she would be sitting here looking at all of you, people who love and care about her. I can just see her sitting here amongst us, all the flowers and plants, because if you ever sat in her kitchen, she's had flowers and plants were everywhere, and the music and all of the stories and the things that we shared and told each other. She would always just love that part of being together. So I think she just, in, I know she's obviously with us and that she's just loving this moment. So I'm going to now try to get through a song. All right. So Trieste asked me to sing this, and I thought it was pretty apropos for thinking about Lita
and her moving forward into her next part of her life. So, another minute for a second. Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I've heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops, way above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds sing, birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh, why can't I? If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbow, why, oh, why can't I?
This concludes our service for this afternoon. The family and friends have prepared a beautiful luncheon for us down in Fellowship Hall immediately following this service. So God bless you and thank you for coming. And I'm sure the family would appreciate it if you could get downstairs and then you could do more fellowshipping. So God bless you. Thank you for coming. And have a beautiful day. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, bring her too. My grandpa's already up there. So. Bring them all. Knew you were going there. I like it. She would know.
You remember.
Well, I had some louder than his, but I have to get to date. There's another laboratory downstairs. Hope that's not the laboratory line. From Whole Inches Berry, Cyber Press.
It's much better with less motion.
No, it was perfect just the way it was.
Yeah, she would have loved it. Yes. She would have loved it. We sang a lot. I'm good because I have fine teeth.
Okay, you should be
here. That's very generous. We sang a lot together in our little kitchen, and so that was, she was just an absolute beautiful soul.
Thank you.